Okay, student, here's our last installment in the course introduction. Who, of course, doesn't recognize the Death Star, the big Star Destroyer from the movie Star Wars? Now, I'll try to steer clear of science fiction for the most part in this class here, but the Death Star is something sort of outer spacey, yeah? And it turns out that there is something, a moon of Saturn here, called Mimas, that was first photographed by astronomers in 1980 or so, and it has this large feature on it here, which is obviously a large impact crater, so the moon was obviously hit by something very large and hard a long time ago. And if you put the two together, they look almost identical in sort of structure here with the big crater. But what was interesting about this here is the Death Star first appeared in the original Star Wars movie in 1977, and this moon, Mimas of Saturn, wasn't photographed until about 3 years later, 1980. Kind of interesting. Artists in history are often a nice clue about what was going on in the sky, and so there are obviously no cameras back a long, long, long time ago. But in this, tapestry here, this is a depiction of the birth of Jesus. And there's some things in the sky that the artist, for some reason, felt compelled to capture here. And in this particular picture here, this might be the Star of Bethlehem. And I would like to discuss what the Star of Bethlehem might have been back then. Kind of interesting there. Here's a planet, which is a moon of Jupiter called Io or Eo, depending on what side of the Atlantic Ocean you're on here. And there's all this stuff sort of coming out here. So it's sort of a curious item about what exactly is this coming off of this moon here. So we'll talk about that. Here is a full color picture of the moon itself. Again, this is a moon of Jupiter here called Io or Eo, again, depending if you're in Europe or America here. And it just, the moon itself always reminds me of a pizza. It's just completely scarred, has all these different colors on it like this here, and all these features that are just like, what is going on with this moon? It turns out this moon is in being tortured by Jupiter for reasons that I'll tell you here, but this is the moon that's closest to Jupiter. Lastly, as we get on to some of our pictures of the solar system here, some things you're probably familiar with. There's the Sun at the center, and there's Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, and so on, and the large planets as you go out. They even have a comet in here and some asteroid belts. What's very difficult to capture about the solar system is the size of it. For example, in this image right here, the relative size of the planets isn't nearly done properly here. Like, Earth is not this large compared to Jupiter. And so on, and the planets are not spaced this closely, but it's very hard to capture these things because of the size of both the planets and their distances are just very hard to reconcile, but we'll try. But this is one of our first pictures here of our solar system, so it's not bad. And I like sort of talking about the sizes because there's a lot of images like these out there on the internet where you can see, for example, the size of, in this case here, this big object here would be our Sun. And then if you go back down, let's see if I can move this out of the way a little bit. I don't know if I can or not. If you go back and look, then I'm really messing this up, aren't I? These little things that you see here are the other planets. Like, for instance, here's Jupiter and Saturn. So you can see how small they are compared to the Sun. And if you look way over here in the corner, that little planet right above the red dot there, that's Mercury, that's Venus, and that's the Earth right there. And there's Mars right there. So you can see how small these planets are. And if you look right next to Earth, that little dot right there would be our Moon. So you can see how small these planets are compared to, say, the bigger ones, Jupiter and Saturn, and that one that starts with U and Neptune. And there's Pluto and some of the other planets that are still out, that are out there, or not planets, planetoids or objects that are out there. But look how small the Earth is in compared to some other things in the solar system. And this is my last slide here, but just a curious item here. This is the planet Neptune right here, so it has this bluish look. And I'm not sure how much we'll talk about Neptune or what, but it's kind of interesting that this orbit, or so-called how long it takes to go around the Sun once, is actually 164 years. And so by comparison, of course, the Earth takes 1 year to go around the Sun. So Neptune takes 164 years to go around the Sun, and it's just sort of an interesting fact that it was first discovered in 1846 or so. So if you just sort of add 1846, its discovery year, with 164 years of its orbit, that brings us sort of to 2010. And so what am I telling here? Well, since it was first discovered back in 1864, we've witnessed Neptune only make about one plus or so orbits. Like, it hasn't even traveled that far in its orbit because it's so far from the Sun, it takes so long to go around. We've only seen it as I said, orbit like, say, less than 2 times since we ever first saw it for the first time. So there's all kinds of fun stuff like that in astronomy. So with that, students, I'm done with my introduction to the class. So the next videos, we'll get on to our first real astronomical topics.